Hey there guys, Mike1217 here, welcome back to Let's Play Majora's Mask, and we are back in Snowhead, and as you can see here, with time reset, everything is back to the way it was before we finished the temple, and that is because we reset time. That's kind of a depressing point with this game, is even though we went through all that trouble going through Snowhead Temple and defeating that boss, and making things well in Snowhead in our last cycle, now that we reset time, that's all been erased, and now things aren't well again, and the land is covered in snow. Really is a depressing point of this game, and, you know, it kind of illustrates the fact that things aren't totally well in Termina, even though you're doing all these things and going through all these trials. You know, things aren't totally well in Termina until you take care of the big picture, which is the Skull Kid and the evil mass that is possessing him. So that's just something I figured I'd point out. This is post-narration, by the way, in case you couldn't tell. I'll explain just really quick that I'm gonna be post-narrating the majority of this episode because I just wasn't just... Long story short, I wasn't happy with the live commentary here. There will be one part of this episode that will still have that I kept the live commentary from. But yeah, most of this is going to be post-commentary, so sorry about that. I just decided it was for the betterment of the episode. So what I'm going to be doing in this episode is actually getting the sword upgrade. I don't know how long I wander around here explaining stuff, but yeah, we're gonna be getting the sword upgrade here in this episode, and it is a rather complicated process that is spanned out throughout the 3 days, so you want to make sure you begin this process on the first day. And, I'm gonna cut ahead here, because I don't know what I was screwing around doing. Alright, let's see, do I enter the building right here? Yeah, I'm gonna enter the building pretty soon. So, yeah, this is the cabin that you get the sword upgrade from. As you can let's just talk to this guy, let's not get ahead of ourselves. So what we're eventually going to be doing, there's three steps to this, and each step is done on each of the 3 days. The first step is to turn in your Kokiri sword to this guy. Not this big guy, but this guy here. He is the smith of Termina. I don't know exactly what he's called. But his name is Zebora. There we go. Perfect timing. And we'll just go through this text. What we're eventually going to have to do is defeat Goat again, so we will have to purify the land, and actually that's what we're going to do next. We don't really do anything right here. What we need to do is actually thaw out this ice that's covering, like, some kind of, I don't know, some kind of, what is that? I don't know what that thing is that's actually frozen over, but it's some kind of passport or something that we need to thaw out in order for us to actually be able to get our new sword. I guess it's like instructions or something for making the new sword. I'm just gonna assume it's that. So yeah, we need to have that thawed out. What we could have done is gotten some hot spring water and brought it down here to thaw out the ice, but what I'm gonna do instead is just defeat Goat now and purify the land, and that will automatically unthaw, because that'd be freezing again, that'll unfreeze that ice. So that is what I'm going to do. I'm not going to show the entire boss fight again. I will show kind of the process of refighting the boss and kind of what happens there. So I am going to soar ahead and into the temple. We go, and as you can see here, I'll show you this little cutscene. And now that we hold the boss's remains, that's that mass that you get whenever you beat the boss. Now that we hold the remains, the temple recognizes it, and it will give you a warp that takes you straight to the boss. So now we can go in that little Majora's Mask symbol at the beginning of the room, and each temple has this. Once you defeat the boss for the first time, you can warp to the end. just warp straight to the boss. You don't have to get any boss key or anything. I'm gonna show you right here what I kind of mean about, you know, the dungeons resetting when we reset time. You can see that door up there is frozen. This door off to the left is locked. So yeah, everything is reset now, essentially. And that's kind of why you really do need to do the temples in one sitting. Unless you want to use that quick save feature, which I'm not sure if I'll ever use in this playthrough. I probably will. But yeah, we can just warp straight ahead to the boss. As you can see, we're right back here in the room. And I'm going to cut out the fight of it. I will be an honest man and show this. I decided to fight it with my arrows for some stupid reason here, and I got killed. So this is death number 8 or 9, I don't know. I'll have to check back at the previous episodes. But yeah, I did die here. I'm going to be an honest man and show the death. And this should be the killing of the boss. And there you go. I actually did a lot better on that this time around. It went a lot quicker. But yeah, I tried to do a speedrunning tactic. There's a way that you can kind of get them trapped when he's shooting lightning. You can get them trapped with your arrows and just keep shooting them. I failed miserably at that, and that's how I had my first death there. But whatever. We shouldn't have to refight that boss again. And, yeah, now we're just gonna skip ahead to the land being purified, and now we can go into the cabin and turn in our Kokiri sword. So yeah, theoretically, you could actually go through the temple without a sword. Like, you could bring back hot spring water to here and thaw out the ice and turn in your sword before you even begin the temple. And you can go through the temple without your sword. I've seen people do that where they do both the process of getting the sword upgrade and the going through the actual temple, you know, at the same time, in the same cycle, but you would have to go through the temple without your sword. I don't know what day you would have to do that on, but I didn't want to mess with that. That'd just be too much. That would suck. That would suck to have to go through the temple with 3 hearts and no sword. I would not. That'd be going a little too far with me. That'd be like combining the 2 major challenges of the original Legend of Zelda, the swordless run and the 3 heart run, into one thing. I would not do that. So yeah, now we have turned in our Kokiri sword, and he says to come back tomorrow morning, which is the morning of the second day, to get a new sword. So what I'm going to do is first heal and wander around a bunch. I'm going to play the Song of Double Time twice, because it only skips ahead every 12 hours or whatever. Like, playing it one time would skip ahead to the night of the first day, and then playing it another time would skip ahead to the dawn of the second day, which is what we do here. So now, with the dawn of the second day, we will head back into the cabin. I think I screw around a little bit. Sorry about that, but, you know, it happens. And here we're gonna get a temporary sword, which is called the Razor Sword. This sword is kind of the equivalent of the Giant's Knife in Ocarina of Time. It will break after a certain number of usages, so I would not suggest trying to use it. You could use it in the temple if you want to, but I would not suggest it. Because if it breaks, I've never actually had this happen, but I'm pretty sure if it breaks, it turns back to the Kokiri sword, and you might as well just reset the entire process of getting your sword upgrade. So don't even bother using this sword. I wouldn't do it. I think it is more powerful, but ultimately, this is not the sword upgrade we're going for. What we need to do is bring him back some gold dust. And I'll show you how we do that in a bit. We have to bring him back some gold dust. Make sure you don't go ahead on time here just yet. You want to make sure you get this gold dust as soon as possible. So what I'm doing here is getting the powder keg from the Goron in the bomb shop in Clock Town. This is something that does carry over after you do what we did at the end of the last episode, where you prove the giant Goron how to use the powder keg. So I need to get one of these, and what I'm actually going to do here is switch over to my live commentary that I saved from the original recording. So yeah, we're going to be doing live commentary in just a bit. Whee!
This Sword Art guide is kind of a bitch. And you're about to see why in just a bit. This is another really annoying part of the game that I just do not like doing. It's very annoying. It can be kind of fun, I guess. It's another race. Remember that Deku Butler race that we did at the end of Woodfall, like after we did beat the boss there? That pissed me off. This is another race that's going to piss me off, but it is a little bit more fun than that, at least. And you're racing multiple characters instead of just one guy. And actually, really, the Butler thing wasn't really a race, it was just keep up with them. Okay, so here we can easily just drop down a equipable powder keg this time around instead of getting it from the Bigoron that sells it. That actually blew up pretty quickly, I'm surprised. I was about to put on an arrow and shoot it. But yeah, now that we opened that, there is more to blowing up that rock than proving to that Goron that we can use the powder keg. There is actually something behind this door, and it is the race that I'm talking about. This is what this episode is mostly going to be featuring. It's this really annoying but also kind of fun race. Our prize for winning this race will be Gold Dust, and that is what the smith in that cabin, who's taking care of our sword, that is what the smith is going to use to make our new sword. So that's what we're going for here. So, here we go. The Goron race, the dreaded Goron race. I hate this, and I love it at the same time. Now, what I have to do here is try to get a head start. Sometimes you might screw that up and go too early, and they'll just say, hey, don't cheat, and then you'll just start over. But yeah, it's a race to the end, that's really all there is to it. And this is really annoying because the Gorons can really fuck you over here whenever they bump into you. Sometimes I like to think this is luck. If you do get screwed over, don't get too discouraged. I had to just try to stay away from the Gorons as much as possible. That's my advice, stay away from them. Fuck this, I hate this race. See, like, even if you get stopped up like this, don't worry, you can catch up. You can catch up to this really easily. I don't really know what the best strategy is here. I don't have a good way of doing this, I wish I did. Because I know a lot of people hate this, I do too. And a lot of it's just hoping you don't bump into these guys too much. At the end here, you can really just pull ahead of them. Like, I think I might have this. I want to knock on. Just stay on the inside. Use your Mario Kart tactics. Stay on the inside. And you just keep going straight. I think I might have it first try. Did I do it? I think I did. I can't tell. That was great. Okay, thank God. First try. That usually gives me a hell of a lot more trouble than that. Oh, I'm so happy. I am so happy that this is done. This is one of my most hated parts of the game. But it is a lot of fun, too. I just hate failing at it. Okay, so I got what I want, and let's get the hell out of here.
That is why I saved that live commentary, because I kind of wanted to get my live reaction to getting that race in the first try. Anyway, yeah, we'll bring the gold dust back here, and present it to the smith here, if I ever decide to talk. I don't know, I guess this guy is the guy who actually uses the hammer and creates the sword. This guy's kind of his boss. Ugo, well, I don't know what the hell. No, his name is like Gabora. Like, his name reminds me of Capo Gabora. I don't know if he has any relation to the owl. I'm pretty sure a big, muscly guy is not related to a owl, but I digress. So, now that we give him the gold dust, this actually does give us a new empty bottle, by the way. So that is another thing that we get out of this, is our second empty bottle. And now that we give him the gold dust, we'll have to fast forward time again to the third day. So this is step three, is coming back on the third day and getting the final sword. So yeah, this is all done, and I'm just going to go in and get my sword, and that's going to be it. For this episode, it's just basically this whole sword upgrade. Sorry again about the whole commentary confusion here. But I felt like it was just the best thing to do for this episode. So this is the final sword upgrade of the game, kind of. It is the Gilded Sword, and I will show you just how powerful this thing is in the next episode of Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. And I'm going to be resetting time here. I might as well show you the time resetting thing again, just if you haven't seen it in a while. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. This has been Mike1217, and I will see you in a new cycle where we will actually work on getting our horse, Epona, back. So, see you next time for that.